What kind of particles exist? What correlation is there between the particles? That's the fundamental question. If you think about looking at this microcosm and thus being able to explain how the universe is put together, it's all the same physics that you can understand through this detailed research. My name is Markus Klute, and the focus of my research is experimental particle physics.
Markus Klute was at CERN in Geneva in 2012 when physics history was written. Back then, the researchers were able to detect the Higgs particle at the CMS detector, which prior to that was only known in theory. The Higgs particle, or boson, is considered to be the origin of one of the basic properties of all things, mass.
This is precisely the experiment through which we're trying to find out how the Higgs boson behaves. Right now, we're preparing the experiment for the next data collection because this afternoon, the magnet will be powered up again. The biggest magnet in the world.
The largest magnet is in the detector at the CMS experiment, and it is connected to the so-called Large Hadron Collider, LHC, a particle accelerator with a circumference of 27 kilometers, the longest in the world. The LHC accelerates the protons almost to the speed of light, and they collide at four points. The CMS detector can be used to measure different particles that are created when the protons collide. The search for further, still unknown, Higgs particles continues. At CERN, dark matter research is also being advanced through Markus Klute's contribution.
This international exchange is extremely important for research because you then have such a diverse pool of people answering the same question together. And examining the question against different backgrounds, you can also make progress in research.
In Karlsruhe, Markus Klute is directly connected to the CMS experiment at CERN. And when protons in Geneva are colliding 40 million times per second, a flood of data also arrives in Karlsruhe, which is being organized by Markus Klute and his team.
If you then try to analyze the data, it doesn't really matter where it's located because you have direct access to it. You can analyze it effectively and then produce physical results. And one of these centers is GRIDCAR here in Karlsruhe. The data is stored here directly after it's been processed by CERN. It's being stored, but also made available for these analyses.
In Karlsruhe, components are also being manufactured that will be used when the CMS detector is overhauled in the coming years, in order to significantly increase particle collisions in the accelerator.
When you work in particle physics, it's important that you're relatively broadly positioned and really understand the experiment. That includes data analysis and how the detector works in detail and how to actually build one.
All-rounder Markus Klute, who moved to Karlsruhe from MIT, brings his broad knowledge and many international contacts with him to KIT in Karlsruhe.
I'd like to further develop my research here in Karlsruhe, and the opportunities that the Alexander von Humboldt Foundation provides are actually the framework for that. The research focus is on the experiments at CERN, but here in Karlsruhe, we really want to prepare new experiments, new research directions, and work on ensuring that the future of particle physics also takes a direction that is interesting for me.
Endurance is something he also demonstrates in his free time.
You can't just run a marathon. You have to prepare for it. Research is very similar to that. You have to work on the problem consistently. And sometimes it takes months, sometimes years, until you achieve a result.